Ystävämme aaltolaiset, hyvät naiset ja herrat, lämpimästi tervetuloa Aalto-yliopiston lukuvuoden 2016-2017 avajaisiin. Kära Aalto Iter, varmt välkomna till inskriptionen för Aalto-universitetet och invigningen av vårt sjunde läsår tillsammans.
Dear Aalto community, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the seventh opening of the academic year here in Aalto University. My name is David Leal Martinez, and I'm a doctoral candidate from the School of Electrical Engineering.
And my name is Jenny Ylander. I'm a master's student from the IDBM program at Aalto. And it's absolutely fantastic to be with you all here in Otaniemi today. Otaniemi is becoming the home of the campus, but as we all know, a place is nothing without its people.
Because we believe that Otaniemi is not just about the buildings. It's about those conversations, those late-night projects, those extraordinary moments that eventually become Otaniemi stories. We were asked today to come and share a bit of our Otaniemi stories with you. So Jenny, would you mind starting?
Well, there's quite many stories here from Otaniemi for my part, but I've been thinking about the meaning for me, Aalto, what Aalto means to me. And I came to the campus in 2013, but I was not even a student back then. More specifically, I was heading towards Startup Sauna, and that day became one of the first of hundreds of days here as where I spent working for Slush. For the first years, my Otaniemi story involved a little less lectures and somewhat more pizza and pitching competitions. And I think that tells a lot about the entrepreneurial community and the spirit at Otaniemi campus. To me, Aalto means being open, collaborative, and welcoming. And that was the reason why I applied to the master program here. The Otaniemi campus has become a symbol for some of the most important years in my life, which is why it's an honor and a privilege to be here with you all today.
Thank you so much, Jenny. So I had surely underestimated the power of entrepreneurship and pizza. So may I please welcome our first speakers to the stage to share with us their, not only their Otaniemi stories, but also what's in store for us this new academic year in Aalto University. So may I invite President of Aalto University, Tuula Teeri, and the President of the Student Union, Milja Asikainen.
Arvoisa ministeri, hyvät opiskelijat, dear colleagues and students, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 2016 opening ceremony of Aalto University. My own Otaniemi story began when I was warmly welcomed by all of the Aalto students 1st of April 2009 when I was just appointed to president of Aalto University. I was given a student overall haalari, as you all know. You see some of them here today, full of symbols of all the three founding universities of Aalto University. And I was also given a tour of all the students' secret places here in Otaniemi, but also the places that are important for the students in Töölö and Arabia. And it was also, I had to actually give some promises during that tour, so the students don't let you go easily, you know. So I was sworn to always defend and speak for all the students, come rain or shine, and that is a promise that I really made my best to keep, and I always will. This day was really awesome. It was a memorable beginning of something really exciting, inspiring, something very important it felt, and it still does. It was a promise of a meaningful future for all of us. Also on that day, I received a plate that carried an engraved text, "Welcome to the Technology Village." Tervetuloa Teekkarikylään, Tuula. We have come quite a long way after that day. We are still here in the Teekkarikylä, but in a Teekkarikylä, which is actually rapidly becoming a city, and a city that is already home to all of our different disciplines, and also our partners and our friends. So we are rapidly becoming the innovation university that we were founded to be, thanks to the hard work of our faculty, our staff, our students, and of course, our partners. So we are today welcoming a whole new cohort of Aalto students who will begin their higher education to learn and experience what an academic education is at best. So welcome also back all of those students who are already well on their way with their education. So Milja, what do you think? What are your thoughts? What should we think about when guiding our students on the first days of their academic journey?
Yeah, maybe I started with my Otaniemi story. My time here in Otaniemi started about 1 year later than yours, Tuula. The couple of worst weeks were a hustle. It felt like I was running from an orientation lecture to another, hearing so many times that I made a great decision by coming to Aalto. One of the most memorable events was organized by my own student association, the Guild of Physics. On the first day, us freshmen were walking towards one of the lectures. By the door of the bachelor center, a huge number of older students were gathered, waiting for us. They all had their overalls on. They formed an honorary alley through which we walked in the beat of Imperial March. It was both super weird and kind of exciting. It was one of those moments when students did something that they find fun, regardless of the opinions of the others. During the first weeks, I learned how the university works. But most importantly, I found a community that welcomed me. As probably all the students in this room agree on, the first days and weeks are extremely important in a student life. They make a great deal in how the students integrate to Aalto community. Students starting their university life is definitely something that the university and student community have to concentrate on. It's the foundation for everything coming later. But Tuula, what do you think that are the key things that we should teach to the new generation of students? What is the core of academic education at this time and also in the future?
Yes, that's a good question, Milja. We think about it very much, especially when we are welcoming a new cohort of students. And I think the key really is that if you look at modern societies, we have really built them based on knowledge, and we must continue to build them based on knowledge. So this is how we really can keep up building constantly a better world, which is able, which is equal, and which is caring. And if we look around us at this day and age, as you were saying, as knowledge as such, as the basis of societal development, seems to be less and less valued at the moment. I think we all know about Brexit and we know about Turkey. We shouldn't forget Mr. Trump with his arguments that have no scientific basis whatsoever, or any other basis for that matter. Both the general public and our elected decision makers seem less and less concerned or troubled with knowledge or the actual state of things as evidence has it. Populistic remarks are countered with other populistic remarks, even here in Finland. This is a very dangerous and very worrying development. What do you think, Milja? How should we handle this?
The culture of not valuing expertise is the reason why everyone in the Aalto community, the students, professors, the whole community, should more and more participate in public discussions. No one is coming to our doorstep to ask our opinion or give the science perspective if we don't do it ourselves. Universities and their people should take a bigger role in directing the public discussions and not just adapting to it.
Yes, to have a solid base for such a discussion in our society and globally, we must actually have knowledge that is constantly improving. This is why we need creative frontline research. We must be pioneers in some areas of strength. Otherwise, we will be followers. We will always be one step behind. Universities, in my mind, have a huge responsibility for safeguarding the knowledge society, in developing new knowledge and insisting on advocating knowledge-based decision-making. And to be able to do this, what society needs is critical thinkers in all sectors of society, just now probably more than ever before. And we at universities must educate them generation after generation. We need more and more people that have a wide knowledge base, capabilities to build new knowledge, and to evaluate, understand, and form an opinion based on facts. These critical thinkers must be confident and bold enough to speak and to defend knowledge society.
Yeah. But interesting question here is how to get these critical thinkers interested in solving the problems in the society, and also not being afraid of politics. The student union is having this in the focus for the next 2 years. We try to get the students interested in discussions going in the society and finding their own way to be influential. And I think this is a lot about culture. And my opinion is that the university should encourage people to have debates and wanting to make a change.
Yes. So,
yeah. What do you think that the university should do for changing this culture?
I agree with you completely. And I think that we all need to be interested in participating in the public discussion and also the way, sort of shaping the way that we do things in the society. I think the academic community worldwide still has some challenges in this part. But also I think that discussion as such is not quite enough, but we also must act to change things. And our students really must learn to do instead of only talk. Talking is important, but doing is even more important. And I think willingness to participate is indeed something that can be encouraged by the right kind of culture. And it's something that all teachers and every student can play a part in.
But do you have some examples how we should do this?
Yeah, we do. We do indeed have many great examples at Aalto for such a passion for participation. We, for instance, have a lot of scientists here, many scientists that work for and talk about how to build ecologically sustainable technologies and responsible business practices, for instance. Our student entrepreneurs are very active, a very visible advocate of an entrepreneurial culture and practices. And our economists are advising the government on how to put together the ingredients of new growth. This is just a few examples of that. And I think it's really, really important for us in education to engage our students in all of our activities as early as possible, to join research groups and industrial collaboration and international missions, as we have many excellent examples of, and in learning also how to speak for themselves, how to lead, whether it's a question of a debate or artwork or technology development or business creation.
Yeah. I think it's important that students have a possibility to learn what the working life is like and what kind of career possibilities there are. It often takes time and errors to find your own path and what really motivates you. Having the possibility to find the things you're passionate about also benefits the society. That's the way innovations are made. Working beside studies and being active on student organizations also teaches skills needed by future working life. This includes, for example, teamwork, social skills, group leading, and project management.
That's very true. I think universities must be able to provide the students with skills are needed by their future employers. Although I must say that it's not a very simple task at the moment, as we really can't predict what the jobs will look like, even after a couple of years when our current students are graduating. This is something that we are at Aalto are working all the time quite hard, the goal being that we can provide our students a very high quality disciplinary excellence, which is then augmented by art, creativity, multidisciplinary collaboration and entrepreneurship. Trusting that this kind of education with many possibilities to choose from to shape one's own curriculum will give the necessary means then to change the world. Our students are already very actively engaged in societal challenges. We are constantly developing our programs towards integrative thinking. We are sure, we trust that this will increase the impact of the university and the relevance of the education that we provide.
Yeah, I think that the studies in Aalto are developed so fast at the moment that I almost feel like being freshman again. For example, the options for multidisciplinary studies is increasing rapidly, and I really hope that all the new students take advantage of that. The societal impact of education and research is the key for solving problems in Finland and worldwide. Dear Minister, I really hope that the universities get enough appreciation for their work in the future.
So when it comes to the societal impact of university research and education, we are really very pleased that the Ministry will be starting to evaluate the impact of universities more extensively in the future. Because we earn over half of our funding from the Ministry to carry out our core activities, which by law include research, education and interaction with the society. And it's really critical for our success and also to the success of Finland that we can earn our funding from the Ministry using relevant criteria of all of our tasks. So Aalto University is indeed performing really well in creating value from research and education by our faculty, by our students and our partners participating in developing the Aalto entrepreneurial and innovation ecosystem. Over half of all the startups coming out of Finnish universities originate from Aalto. Our student community with its alumni partners has generated slush, among other things, which is not only known worldwide, but it also has done a tremendous job in changing the general attitudes of Finns that have about the entrepreneurship. Also, university collaboration adds value to corporations. This has been shown in numerous reports over and over again in different parts of the world. And this is also true for Aalto. Collaboration with us does increase the competitiveness of our partners and it leads to more jobs. So Milja, what would you say are the key messages that we must emphasize during the next 4 years?
Yeah. Firstly, the universities are vital for solving the problems in the society. Secondly, changing the public atmosphere towards education and science is responsibility for every person in all the community, including students, professors, researchers, everyone. And thirdly, it's super important that we get students interested in societal issues and solving the problems.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's nice to have this kind of a dialogue because instead of 3 points, you can actually have 6. So here are my 3. So we must continue to advocate for the role of research, education and innovation in developing a globally successful knowledge economy. And I really would like to invite our politicians to turn their attention to an open dialogue with experts both in Finland and globally. I think that because we have to be able to compete globally, I think that international advice for decision making will be and is crucial. We, I think, also need a national dialogue that sets a bold vision for the future and that generates a basis for systematic and long-term development of our research and innovation system. A vision and an action plan that hopefully carries over different government programs and governments. Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure and honor to invite the Minister of Education and Culture, Sanni Grahn-Laasonen, to give a speech on behalf of the Government of Finland. Please welcome.
Honorable Rector, Vice Rectors, Deans, esteemed professors of the university, dear staff and students, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. For me, Otaniemi is a campus of opportunities, campus of opportunities of the future. Aalto University was born out of the very bold and ambitious idea of creating a new world-class university. Campuses have been an important element in constructing the new university. They have been turned into open and innovative forums by opening the premises and activities to partner companies and student-driven projects. This is what Otaniemi represents today. Otaniemi and Aalto University have a strong perception of their own identity, combined with a highly international staff and work culture and a large number of international students. The opportunities for Otaniemi in the near future arise from the three main fields of the Aalto University: technology, economics, and art and design. They are to be brought together in this campus by the year 2020. I believe that this joint effort will bring important new opportunities for developing education and research at the Aalto University. In the new strategy of the university, there is greater emphasis on interdisciplinary approach and on reinforcing innovation and entrepreneurship ecosystems. And the opportunities get even better when art and artistic thinking is integrated into all this. While technology changes the way we live, the global community that used to consist of peoples and nations is now more interconnected than ever. There is no longer just one way of anything. There is not only understanding of the world, but many. There is not one understanding of the world, but many conflicting viewpoints. There is no longer just one truth, but a multitude of voices proclaiming each their own. This is a big challenge for traditional learning, which has focused on giving the students a set of skills in a limited field. And traditionally, the deeper the knowledge, the narrower the field. This way of thinking and learning as a philosophy of education is becoming more and more problematic. Instead, what is needed in the working and academic life of tomorrow are multidisciplinary, interconnected skills. Aalto University is a place where many fields and disciplines meet, so you have excellent possibilities to break boundaries and to aim for the top. I hope to see in the future, for example, cultured technologists, philosophical business leaders, and science-oriented artists. Why not? You, the students, and the staff of the Aalto University are in the key position in constructing the university of the future and the campus it deserves. The Otaniemi stories of tomorrow are being written today. Dear guests, we have heard many words about digitalization already. Digitalization changes markets, it changes the way we do business, it changes the way we work, the way we play. The real question is, what are our conclusions? Instead of just pretty words about change, we need to really change the way we think in our educational institutions, our workplaces, and also in the way we manage and regulate our society. Digitalization is not essential, it's rather a symptom. It's a symptom of rapid technology-driven change in our society. What is the significance of this change? It reminds us that we must be prepared. We must expect the unexpected. We cannot go back to playing the snake game, as we used to do, Matopeli, on our mobile phones, when our kids are screaming for Pokemon or something else that we don't have yet. We cannot have an economy based on the past. We need education that helps us invent the next big thing and understand that it too will have a limited lifespan. Our greatest innovations will most likely one day be forgotten. When this happens, we must be able to move on and come up with the next one. We as a society must stop being afraid of change. That's why the future calls for a new thinking, foresight, wisdom, creativity, and critical thinking, a special kind of preparedness that comes from multifaceted learning and openness to new things. That is what you must receive from your education here in this institute. Dear students of Aalto, this is what you must expect and what you must demand of your professors. Ladies and gentlemen, working together, bold foresight and new ways to act, this is what all Finnish universities need. The aim is that by 2025, the Finnish universities are highly competitive internationally and produce the kind of knowledge that is needed to solve the global problems while also boosting the renewal of the Finnish society on the basis of knowledge and science. Universities must have the capacity to change and to be pioneers of change in the society. I also have some Otaniemi stories of my own. Ne liittyy ennen kaikkea Otaniemen moniin salakapakoihin, mutta ei ehkä niistä sen enempää. With these words, I wish the students and the staff of the Aalto University success, courage and joy for this academic year. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Tack Tuomas. Tuomas är en iPad-musiker som har utexaminerats från Sound in New Media på Media Factory. Och allt vi hörde nyss spelades live. Men hej, David, nu är jag nyfiken på att höra din Otaniemi-story.
Jättekiva, so it's my turn. Well, my story starts back in 2009, when I came to Finland to study the Space Master program, and I saw that Finland was a bit different from the rest of the world, starting with the no siesta, yes coffee approach to productivity. But well, I had a close encounter while living here in Otaniemi, but in the student village. And I remember very vividly this one day that I was walking out of the student village and I saw this traffic sign on top of a normal traffic sign saying, Muu Suomi. And then I said, well, this is not only different from the rest of the world, but it's also very different from the rest of Finland, or so they say. And I thought I got the joke, but in reality, I didn't get the joke. It took me some years, and I remember very well one day, one person came to me and told me, David, I have this challenge. I want to prove some high-end executives in a large company that I will avoid to say the name, that we can build a humanoid robot in 5 weeks and having it selling equipment in Germany. And actually, 5 weeks later, we managed to deliver. And that's when I thought, I wonder if any other place or any other community would have managed to pull this one off. Because I see that here in Otaniemi, there is a great mix of academia and the real world. This is a place where research meets the final user and where any person can bring their grain of sand into the fabrics of science.
Wow, space and robots, you're basically the Elon Musk of Aalto. So we have 600 Otaniemi stories in this room, and I think we have one that actually has prepared a little something for us over here. So, Reetta, would you mind?
Thank you. Moikka, mä olen Reetta Ojala, mä olen 5. vuoden geoinformatiikan opiskelija. Mä mietin hetken aikaa mun Otaniemi-tarinaa ja tässä keväällä, kun aloitan diplomityön tekemistä, niin tuli jo ihan haikea mieli, että mitähän kaikkea tässä on tehnyt ja kohtahan tämä loppuu. Aloitin siis 4 vuotta sitten täällä ja ajattelin, että tuun tänne opiskelemaan diplomi-insinööriksi. Mutta aika nopeasti selvisikin, että tulin oppimaan tänne paljon muutakin. Musta tuli teekkari, lähdin mukaan kaikkiin kiltatoimintaan, mä olen maanmittari. Ja kiltatoiminnassa on ollut mukana tuutoroinnissa, kulttuurihommissa ja kansainvälisissä hommissa. Tänä päivänä istun teekkarijaostossa ja johdan KVTMK:ta, eli kansainvälisistä toimikuntaa, josta osa istuu mun kanssa täällä tänään. Ja olen oppinut todella paljon ryhmätyöskentelyä, johtamista ja yhteisöllisyyttä. Ja siitä, että Aallossa on paljon voimaa just siinä poikkitieteellisyydessä. Tämän kaiken kulttuurin ja vapaaehtoistyön vastapainoksi päätin elvyttää mun vanhan harrastuksen kanssa henkiin ja perustin viime vuonna uuden cheerleading-ryhmän tänne Otaniemeen. En millään halunnut poistaa tätä Otaniemestä mihinkään muuhun joukkueeseen. Nyt vuoden ajan toiminut joukkue niin on yli 40 harrastajaa ja piti perustaa vielä uusi ryhmäkin, että kaikki mahtuu Aalto-saliin tuonne Otahallin harrastamaan. Meitä voi tulla moikkaamaan tuonne Aalto-partyyn tästä tämän jälkeen.
Hei, ihan mahtavaa. Mikä tämä Aallon virallinen kannustushuuto sitten olisi?
Mikähän se voisi olla? Varmaan joku Aalto University, Art, Business and Technology, Teamwork is our philosophy.
No niin, yes, mahtavaa.
Thank you so much, Reetta. As we can see, there's all sorts of excellent Otaniemi stories in every corner, and some of them will be awarded today.
Seuraavaksi palkintojen jako. Tuula, ole hyvä.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is always the most fun part of the opening ceremony, to be able to acknowledge people at Aalto, teams at Aalto, that have done something special in the last annual cycle or the academic year. So I will start by announcing the Aalto Act of the Year, and to assist me, I will ask our Vice President of Education, Eero Eloranta, to join me here at the stage. So Aalto Act of the Year Award 2016 goes to the Head of International Relations, Aalto Marianna Suurmenne, Vice President Professor Hannu Seristö, and Professor Turkka Keinonen. Would you please join me here on the podium to receive your prize? So this year's Aalto Act of the Year Award is delivered for this team for skillfully and patiently negotiating and initiating the Shanghai International College of Design and Innovation with Aalto University as the international partner of Tongji University. This is an outstanding achievement of long-term international partnership development, education export, which is kind of in its initiative steps at Aalto nowadays, and commissioned education at Aalto University, which also is supported by China at the national level. Before I hand out the awards, I also would like to acknowledge the contributions of Professor Yrjö Sotama, Rector Emeritus of the University of Art and Design Helsinki, whose efforts already before Aalto University were essential in establishing this relationship with Tongji University. But now, for the team, the awards. And please stay here on the stage, on the side, you know, for there will be more awards. So, ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to this team. This is not the end of the awards, but there will be more awards. And so we will now move on to the Success Enabler Award. And I would like to ask our respected Chief Financial Officer, Marianna Boom, here with me to deliver this award. So the Aalto Success Enabler 2016 award goes to Kati Eriksson, Ivo Paukkeri, and Lauri Ehanti of Aalto Endowment Team. Please come forward to the stage. Here they come. It's very dark looking from here, so I wasn't quite sure if you have escaped this event. So, the Success Enabler Award this year is coming because one of our key goals in Aalto University is that we have to enable in the service function the academic mission of Aalto community as a first priority. And to compete globally for the best faculty and students, staff and partners and other stakeholders, we need to ensure world-class conditions for our research, art, education and collaboration. And for this, we need to build excellence in everything that we do. So this university endowment team is a great example of how our wholehearted dedication to excellence. In their work, the team has demonstrated high degree of expertise and professionalism in endowment management, dedication to research-based knowledge, hard work and responsibility toward their duties.
takaisin joukkoon. So congratulations for all of you, and I think we will go a little bit closer to each other so can we have a fantastic picture of all of you with me. I am so proud of you. closer to the photo, and a little bit to the... All right, are we all visible now? Thank you so much and congratulations. You see how we are in the hands of the artist. Congratulations. So, and the best part of my job continues. So, now we will be announcing the new Aalto Distinguished Professor, and I would like to invite the Provost of Aalto University, Ilkka Niemelä, here to help me announce this. So, it is my great pleasure and honor to announce a new Aalto Distinguished Professor, Professor Juha Varto, please come to the stage. So Juha Varto has been promoted to Professor Aalto Distinguished Professor in recognition of his significant academic merits. Professor Varto has published prolifically, and written diversely and open-mindedly, especially on phenomenology, research methodology for human sciences, aesthetics, pedagogy, and philosophy of the body and sensuousness. He has written and edited several general textbooks on subjects in his research fields. He has appeared frequently in media and produced over 100 programs on philosophical questions for Finnish radio and television. Professor Juha Varto has been a key actor in developing artistic and other forms of research carried out at art universities, sometimes challenging the traditional scientific research approach. In the area of pedagogics, Professor Varto has displayed played an essential role as the developer of art pedagogy and a constant questioner of its established ways of thinking at Aalto University, in other universities, as well as in the Hollo Institute and international networks in the field of art education. Congratulations. Nimityskirja. Sieltä tulee kukkia. Onneksi olkoon. And now it's my pleasure to invite Professor Varto to give the Aalto talk of 2016. Please.
Thank you. So, dear colleagues, young and old, for almost 20 years I have worked at Arabia Campus, but even I have my Otaniemi story. My Otaniemi story is rather short and modest. I have visited Otaniemi mostly because of meetings at the Aalto headquarters or some social happenings, and that doesn't happen very often. The exception from this was when I was the member of the first Aalto tenure track committee.
The committee was to create, in practice, everyday working, the policy of hiring professors that are qualified enough to build up Aalto as it was in our imagination when we started. In its actions, the committee was quite strict. One member, himself an academy professor and highly valued in foreign universities, said aloud what many of us thought in those days. He said, "We are applying criteria under which none of us would be qualified enough to become a professor at Aalto." I'm not telling you much of the committee work, since that committee work is very much like Vegas. What happened there stays there. The workings of the committee provided me with much food of thought. Earlier, I have written several texts, even textbooks, on research methods. That has been in my interest since the first days of my studies, in those days studies in theatre and dance. Theatre and dance were taking their first steps in research in the contemporary sense of the word. In the end of the 60s, varieties of semiotics were very fashionable. For some people, it's still fashionable. I could closely observe in my studies in theatre a scholar who was manically applying semiotics into anything, often with strange, even ridiculous outcome. But it was very inspiring. I as well decided, exactly in those days, to follow a rule I found in a classic text: any area of practice is entitled to its kind of knowledge. That maxim has not been easy to follow. And in academic world, the structures are quite rigid, and often they are mostly about power, not research, neither knowledge. Some mantras are kept on saying just to consolidate the impression that we all think the same manner and we know. The Aalto tenure-track committee was a positive experience. It was the total opposite of, for example, the academic community of philosophers or pedagogical sciences that I knew best. In evaluating the proposals sent us by school tenure-track committees, the members of the committee were well prepared to take into consideration the differences of academic disciplines, the schools of thought, traditions, practical backgrounds, and also cultural differences. The consequence was that we often discussed the differences between the conceptions of knowledge, what follows from those, and how to encourage more open-minded decisions, not only in the committee, but also as a model for the recruitment groups in schools and departments as well. I was delighted to hear that the members really provided arguments for a variety of knowledges, for the necessity of variety. It was as well argued for a more varied understanding of differences in research practice, conceptions of knowledge, and more pioneering, even avant-garde compositions of actual research programs. At Aalto, a university with multidiscipline structure, such a pioneering platitude is almost, or let's say utmost, necessity. Naturally, we must take into consideration the political framework and thus also talk about impact, input, and effect. Others evaluate us, that is the outside. We ourselves are clever if we protect the inside and have several opportunities, be they research groups, committees, or even department meetings, where a kind of transgression is esteemed. There are several areas left in the shadow, grey areas, and even forbidden areas that need our attention. There are questions not asked, and those asked badly or wrong. Even here, to righten the wrong can change the world. It will better the world. A transgressive attitude questions the limits history and custom have bestowed us with. Being transgressive has also the meaning of committing a sin in Christian sense, denying the order given from above. In research and knowledge, that sin we must commit. In transdisciplinary research, it is the knowledge that becomes the most important. Pushing the limits reveals a new image. The world, the nature, has as many faces as we are capable to meet. Each discipline is valuable because of its best achievements, its approaches, its methods, its argumentation, and the evidence it yields. When the limits are transgressed, the mind refocused, then become illuminated to different approaches, methods, argumentation, and evidence. Different indicates strange, odd, curious. It indicates not familiar. They may be familiar for others, but not yet for us. I am not after any kind of pseudoscience or not science, like Madame Blavatsky's doctrine or psychoanalysis. I'm after the trans areas between well-based research disciplines, already somewhat illustrated, but not openly taken seriously. It is a more open conception of knowledge we need, again and again. It's not the same different kind yesterday as it is today or tomorrow. I give you an example that I know the best. In artistic research, the researcher needs material studies, testing, laboratory work, and art practices. The researcher reposits oneself between well-known skills, lesser familiar knowledge, and a novel combination of these. One must relocate, reaffirm, and reinterpret one's doings again and again. Beforehand, no limits are given in artistic research. Any knowledge is accepted. All methods are taken seriously and applied to a need. The knowledge thus created opens up into several discourses, must be evaluated from various disciplines, and can be valuable for other areas of research. Similar demarcation naturally happens in most disciplines. They just, by the nature of researching mind, turn into transdisciplinary practice. In our discussions, what is needed is encouragement. Young researchers, often those who apply for doctoral studies, have already a transdisciplinary mind. They don't believe in confinements they are taught to believe. They even apply to unfamiliar departments just to test where people would be ready to transgress, to discuss the barriers transmitted by tradition, to be ready to unmake the system, unmake the culture as we know it, and perhaps even unmake the world in a good sense. We often publicly regard, at least the past ones, the pioneer work done by scholars with a vague idea only, no fancy facilities, no acceptance from the side of their peers. That state of mind is still needed and must be encouraged when found. In a transdisciplinary university, it is not science that is in focus, but research. Not scientific principles, but knowledge making. When we step to the borderlines, innovations will appear like a spray. Have a great day and an academic year full of innovations and transgressions. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much and congratulations, Professor Juha Aarto, for a new Aalto Distinguished Professor, and to all of our award winners of today.
On tullut aika saattaa avajaisseremonia päätökseen. Haluan tässä välissä myöskin kiittää Luca Appelbergia artsista, visuaalisista, kauniista taustoista, joista ollaan nähty tänään. Ja huh, miten mahtavia tarinoita ollaan saatu kuulla Otaniemi Storiesin kautta. Muistakaa jakaa omia Otaniemi-tarinoita ja lukekaa lisää käyttämällä hashtagia Otaniemi Stories. Vi har hört många unika Otaniemi stories idag och vi önskar att vi kan få höra ännu fler berättelser så att vi kan lära känna oss varandra på hashtaggen Otaniemi stories bättre. Jag tackar för min och Davids del och önskar er alla ett givande läsår.
We would like to thank our guests, our dear audience, our speakers. And toivotamme teille kaikille iloista lukuvuotta tieteen ja opiskelun parissa. Thank you so much.